Yeah.
We are in an Agile practice, so we have to implement Agile loop on organization level. So MD wants people speak in Agile
language.
Top management wants that, middle management don't want. So I can have a control on whole management, I can tell them, we follow this.
So where are you? You are in middle or top or bottom?
So I am an external thing.
Okay, you are an external guy. Okay, great case. Good. Thanks for bringing it up.
I can make them listen, the lower management, you follow Agile, this is what's counting, everything. But middle management doesn't speak. They say it's not working for us. Top management want, he's forcing me, why these guys are not speaking in Agile terms. So how to handle this situation?
Okay, any advice for him?
You probably take the middle management to the top management.
And make them fight in a room. And make a case to fire him. This is the guy who has fired one year for 20%. And you know, firing an external guy is the easiest thing. You need to be careful. True, because external guy doesn't matter, you know. Any advice for him?
Send them for training, the middle management.
Conducting everything, each and everything, we are forcing them to follow something, but say Agile, okay, I have to do a lot of things, doesn't work for me. So if any delay happens in a project delivery, this guy is responsible because of him only I failed. So I don't have any answer. The problem is like convincing people is very difficult.
If you start with a small thing, then you can grow. If we can't grow on
tomorrow's topic is coming.
If I can share my thoughts, right? See, an organization comprises of multiple layers of hierarchy, and each have a different expectation and different roles and responsibilities. There are different set of things that they are accountable for, right? Now, it's easy to say that we'll coach the team, we'll coach the leaders, and then we'll sandwich the middle managers. But what we need to understand is what are the middle managers doing, what are they accountable for, right? For one, there might be a huge scare in their minds that if you as an external person are successful, they might lose their jobs, or you might steal their thunder for them, right? So maybe you want to approach it from that perspective, step into their shoes and say, understand what they want, right? What is it that they're highly resistant to? And then have a conversation with them. And in groups, it might not work out. Maybe you want to take on one-on-ones with them and see what individually each of them have a concern about.
Build the relationships and understand, hear them.
Good.
I take whatever you said. That was a part of it, definitely. See, you have to work on two sides. Here you have two stakeholders. One is the top management who has an expectation, and you have a middle management, you have another expectation, which is contradicting with each other.
They may not actually be contradicting, but the middle management might be accountable for something more than what the leadership thinks, right? So we just need to understand.
The middle manager is accountable for the delivery that they are handling, that's all perfectly right. So in this case, the top manager, in the hierarchy, at least they are more powerful. At least they have the way to force people, even to turn, in the case. So you have two stakeholders, one is a slightly more powerful stakeholder, and another is also an equally important stakeholder, because you can't just like fire a middle manager just because he is not listening to you.
Yes.
So that's a different question. So it is not like very weak, very strong. Two, but relatively stronger. That's the context. You are looking at it from outside.
Yes.
So in the scenario, rather the way at least I would look at it, I have to work on both ends. It is not like only one side. So one side you already covered very well, that you have to understand why, what is the hesitation in the middle management in adopting it to it, because Agile is everywhere. And they, not only we, they are looking at their top management expecting Agile. It is not that the top management talks only to you to ask, make them Agile, and not talking to them to be Agile. That's a very unlikely scenario that they call only the coach secretly and say that make my team Agile. It would not happen in a very likely scenario. So already we have to safely assume some sort of communication is happening between these two, where there is some sort of expectation being set to the middle from the top about being or becoming Agile or talking Agile terms. So that's the base assumption we go with. And then, as he rightly pointed, talk to this team, middle management team, to find out, despite your top management instruction, if you are not doing it, there has to be something. Why you are not able to do, for whatever reasons. Understand that part. And parallelly, you have to work with the top management, either communicating, if the reasons are real, valid, then you have to communicate it as a reflector to top management, or you have to request the top management that whatever you are passing to me was, you should pass to these people also, so that it will help me to rather work with them. As a third person, see, if you talk, to your middle management, the chances of them listening is far higher than me as an external person going and talking with them. So can you help me? You want me to do something, I want your help to do my part, what you ask me to do. So that way, if they go and communicate, it makes my job simpler to like act with them.
That's
and
a very good
get
point.
Yeah, good point. Sadish, you want to do something?
Actually, I will share one scenario, what has happened last 4 months. Okay, I joined in a client location as program manager. Okay, they hired me for transformation of Agile. Okay, they currently we have a huge workflow of 70 projects at a time. Okay, per month, no, it will be flow, will be like that. So another peer manager will be there. No, every day he call me, hey, you do that work, you do that, but you're doing a wrong date added in the project center. Well, every day you told me. I am fed up. So I went and told the hiring manager, okay, he said, please, I cannot able to tolerate all the things. Please release me from the project. I told him, every day I cannot able to tolerate, okay. I went and told the hiring manager. At last, what has happened, right? The scenario, tell me how to make them to that conflict, to remove the conflict with the other peer manager. Program managers are working along.
You are program manager, sorry.
Both are peers, okay. I am a program manager, another program manager will be there. He'll be working as a permanent employee of the company. I am a consultant for an external company.
Okay.
I'm coming and working in the company and doing some Agile transformation.
Right.
But he's not allow them to do transformation. It is for
company. You are transforming his team or
you both are working the same team. Both are working the same projects. Okay. Different way. But he's not allow them to transform.
How two program managers for same team? That structure is.
No, it's just happening. Okay. So okay. Real time scenario is happening.
Right.
But
okay.
They hired me as a transformation guy.
So he will make them a Agile program
manager.
He's already
for convenience. We'll keep him Agile coach and Agile
coach.
Manager. That
okay.
Way is
but he's. But you don't want to make, I have to transform, understood, no? It should be, wants to be, you want to focus to go to traditional only. They want me to
know
what they want me to fail.
Have a leadership blockage.
Sorry.
So the same situation.
I told the senior manager, okay, this is happening for me. Either I should be there in the project or I can go up to the, come up with this project.
Perfect. Okay.
At last what has happened, right? Okay. He called the senior manager, called that another program manager. He told that he'd given the feedback. Okay, this was happened. Then at last, after 2 months, right, he is given transition to me, he is going to some other project.
So it's like he escalated the issue and got it done.
No, see, understood.
Yeah.
No, you should be have courage to go and talk to the senior manager such a way that this was happening. If you're not talking right, you will blame me.
You will be the scapegoat.
You said that Samadhana Beda. Nothing is working, like you have to escalate.
Otherwise, if you keep quiet now, every day your mind will be you're working like a slave, so you have to working for this, you should have peace of mind, right?
So don't be a slave. Yeah. Don't be a slave.
So
if you are feeling that we are just a slave, don't worry, show the courage.
But you should have guts of change, you should have guts that if you go out also, I start away. That
exactly.
Guts you should have.
See, that courage, see, not only this scenario, in my personal opinion, courage is something every coach must have. If you feel vulnerable, it will become very difficult to remove the vulnerability of the people you are working with. Internally, if I am not confident, I can't do it.
Great. So, have a look at this book. And this book tells you to look for, when you listen someone, like listen for a middle management, listen for their needs and feeling. Something Deepak making the point, he's also making the point. Simply, when they are saying, I don't want Agile, you don't listen that they don't want Agile. You start listening to what is their need and what is their feeling. And you address their need and feeling with all the possible things. If you can handle that, you would be listened. If you only listen that I don't want to speak Agile, you will be proving Scrum training, do this, product backlog, why requirement document, where are the user stories.
Proper villain.
Proper villain. So you are in a different mess. I have some need, that's why I'm reacting that way. Listen to that. And this is a general communication style. It can be applied at home, it can be applied at everywhere. Whenever you listen, listen for the need, not for the words. Read this book, 200 rupees approx, I think 250 or something. It can change your life if you start implementing 50% of it. You will be a different guy. Non-violent communication. Yeah, so it will change your life in all aspects. Yeah. So the essence of this book is that all the conflicts happens when you don't listen to the need. Because if somebody says something, you attack the guy. How can you say this to me? So you didn't listen for the need. Classical example is somebody has hit you by the stick. Yeah, the non-violent communication ultimate. I mean, bahut zyada ho gaya. You are not that hurt by the someone. You need to see. Actually, the stick hurted you, and your body made you feel pain. It's your body which is creating a pain, not that particular stick. And the person who has sticked you, what was his need? So he ended up hitting you. So I need to see what feeling, what I need, I heard it, which resulted into me getting sticked by a stick. So if you can do that level of processing, and then you don't attack the stick, but you attack to the feeling which made the person hit you. No, that's why I say, it's a very ultimate example. But yeah, it's like an ultimate example. Maybe we don't reach there. Maybe it's very difficult to reach there. But even if we start thinking, why this guy is hitting me? Why this guy is abusing me? Which need of his, what feeling of, for me is making this happen? Then you may respond in a way which can result a better results. Rather than you also start abusing the guy back. You also start escalating and making this person like hell. And situation will not. So just have a book, have a read of this book. It's a great book for any communicator. And I believe it can resolve a lot of people's domestic problems.
Domestic problems.